Welcome everyone to tableauinfo.com, and today we are going to discuss about cross DB joins versus blending. So let us start with the joins. An SQL join clause combines columns from one or more tables in a relational database. These are the types of joins: self, inner, left outer, right outer, full outer, and cross. So if you don't know much about joins, I paste this very particular link to my YouTube description. There is a video over there so that you know. So this video is all about the comparison between joins versus why I should go with blending instead of joins in some of the cases. Why we still making use of blending while we already have cross DB joins post Tableau 10.0. So this video is more about that part. So if you are not aware about joins, you can always go to my other videos like this. The information will be there at description. Data blending Tableau. What is this data blending? Combining multiple data sources into the same view with the use of common fields between them to join. So you have different data, you can see over there. You have different data sources, you have different query result, and at this stage you are blending the query result finally into the same view. So this is data blending. So now with the cross DB joins also, you would say, okay, with the cross DB joins we are doing the same thing, right? We are blending data, or we are combining data, we are joining data from different data sources. So what is the difference? Why we should make use of blending? Go with blending when data source not supported by cross DB joins. So that makes sense. Cubes and Salesforce are the databases which won't support cross DB joins. Data is at different levels of detail, and this is being marked as red. So I'm going to show you hands-on experience on the red lines over there. Data is at different level of detail. For example, on the right hand side, or maybe I can show you, there are different level of details. One is having city, another one is having state. So these are the different, in such cases when I need to combine or I need to join both the tables, I will make use of blending. Why? You will see later. Data needs cleaning means you have in one of the data source you have field like city, but in the other data source you have field like address where you do have city, but then you will have to clean that. You will have to make that city by making use of truncate, string functions, or you got to manipulate over there. So in such cases also we do make use of blending. Last but not the least, you have lots of data. In those cases also we do make use of blending. So this is the hands-on example that I have for you. We have two Excel sheets, two different data sources, one showing the tourist count for different states and cities, and on the right hand side you see the expected tourist count for the states. So let's first do cross DB join and see what are the challenges, and after that you will see how we do make use of data blending to sort the issues that we will encounter in cross DB joins. So let us start with this example where we have, so there is an intern, Mr. Lakshman. He wants to present the combination of these two data sources. So finally, he want to show we have different states, we have tourist count, and we have expected tourist count. But for the state of Uttarakhand, he did cross DB join and he could find that tourist count is 7,000, that is 4 plus 3 is 7,000 for Uttarakhand, but the expected for Uttarakhand is 1,000, but there he could see 2,000. So that was the wrong analysis. So I can show you now. So you can just download the data sources from this link, this area, download zone, DS1, DS2. I have already downloaded that. So I'll just make use of the same. Let me create a new file. And after that, we'll connect to the data, Excel. First, I'll go with the actual count. I would like this to be as my. Yes. So let me first go with the cross DB join. So we have the actual count I'm adding. expected to RISC-ON. By default, it will do cross DB join, but I would like to get all the states from the actual sheet so that I can get Karnataka as well. Okay, I got it. Now I will make my report. I'll drag state. Fine. I'll convert this to discrete and I'll say to RISC-ON. Makes sense. I'll again convert this to discrete and I'll say expected to RISC-ON. Go back to the data source. Now you can find. That's fine. For UP to RISC-ON is 2000, UP to RISC-ON is 2000, UP to expected to RISC-ON is 2000, UP 2000. Uttarakhand 4 plus 3 7000 and Uttarakhand expected is 2000 there, but actually it is 1000. So my analysis is wrong and I made use of cross DB join. So let me now go to the data source and let me. So that was the suggestion to Mr. Lakshman Singh by Mr. Bharat to make use of data blending instead. So we have actual count over there now. And now we need to remove that because we made those changes, right? Okay, no worries. So now we have this one. I've dragged the sheet. And now I will open the other data source, the expected. Here we go. Now we have both the data sources. So I need to make one primary. So this should be the primary one because I want all these states. So in order to make it primary, remember that you should first drag the columns from the primary, or when you drag first from any of the two data sources, that becomes primary. I hope you know that. To RISC-ON, that's fine. And expected to RISC-ON. So we need to blend it, right? So it's, so if you have same column name, it will automatically blend it. So from there I can, so this is the blending sign. Here you go. My problem is solved now. I can see 1000 as expected to RISC-ON for Uttarakhand. Earlier I was seeing 2000 over there. So what is the problem? In order to understand this, we'll have to go to the next sheet. And this is the important point to remember. For blending, all rows are coming from the primary data source. That's fine, we can see. And aggregated rows are coming from the secondary data source. Then we are combining or we are blending. That means, what is the primary data source there? This one, right? So this is the primary one. The tick mark with the blue background. So all the rows coming from the primary data source, correct? And it says aggregated rows from the secondary data source. Or let me first tell you about the cross DB join, then it will make more sense. That will make more sense actually. So this is blending. So let me do for cross DB joins here. Let me take this as one table. Now I will add the other table. Expected. And I'll have left join so that I can see all the states. So this is cross DB join. So I track city, I drag state, I drag tourist count, and I also drag expected tourist count. So at this point, you would see, okay, this is looking okay. But once I remove city, just see where was the problem here, right? Expected tourist count for Uttarakhand. So here it is coming as 11,000 for Dehradun, Nainital. But when I remove city, you will see that these are being aggregated. 1,000 plus 1,000 plus 1,000 is becoming 2,000. So that is the case with cross DB join. It would aggregate first. So I'm coming to join. Return all the rows from the left table that we saw. Any rows from the right table for the row match that we have seen for the matching row, for the matching region, which is state over here, then aggregate. So that means it would take all the rows from the left-hand side table, which is the actual count table. And afterwards, if I remove city from this very particular view, it would aggregate now. Right? Now it is aggregating to 2000. Where, as in blending, when the rows are coming from the secondary data source, it is already getting aggregated. After that, it is just combining with the primary data source. The aggregation is already done at secondary data source level. After that, it will not further aggregate, but here it will aggregate at cross DB join. You know? So let me show you blending. So here 1000, if I put city over there, it would look similar. 1000, but if I remove it, because it has already been aggregated at secondary data source. So when it is coming from the secondary data source, it is 1000 only. So what is the secondary data source? This is primary, this is secondary. Now I should understand. So this is secondary data source. It is aggregated as 1000. For Uttarakhand, the total tourist count is 1000 only. It is already aggregated. It is not going to aggregate further now. That is the point that you should remember. That is the point to remember. This image, you can take a screenshot of this image. You can just remember this image. That will help you. So blending, all rows from the primary data source, aggregated rows from the secondary data source. Remember this, then combine. Whereas in joins, return all the rows from the left table, any rows from the right table, which is matching, then aggregate. And that is why you see the duplication of data over there at join. I hope it helps. I have made a reprised version of this, when to use data blending and when to use join. I'm going to replace it soon with the original video. So if you have saved the other video somewhere, just keep in mind that this is the next video that you will have in the future. Thanks everyone. I'll see you. Till then, bye.